उजाले खुद ब खुद बोलते हैं, सूरज के निकलने का कभी ऐलान नहीं होता। सर, हम सभी आपके कारण गौरवान्वित हैं और हम आपके पथ पर सदा अग्रसर रहना चाहते हैं। मैं वो मंजर हूं जो आंखों में ठहर जाता है, लिख दे अगर कोई तो असर जाता है। कुछ भी रहा नहीं सर मेरे शब्दों के गुलदस्तों में, नाव कागज की छोड़ रही हूं मैं, अब समंदर की जिम्मेवारी है। हम सभी नदियां आपके सागर हृदय में विलीन हो जाना चाहते हैं। मैं आमंत्रित कर रही हूँ स्वयं डॉक्टर विनोद कुमार पॉल सर को कटिबद्ध निवेदन करके कि अपने शब्दों से, अपने भावों से हम सभी का मार्गदर्शन करें।
धन्यवाद, थैंक यू। रिस्पेक्टेड डॉक्टर संदीप गुलेरिया जी, आप डायरेक्टर, माय ट्विन ब्रदर अशोक देवरारी, माय टीचर्स, फैकल्टी ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट, फैकल्टी ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पीडियाट्रिक्स, डीन्स, मेडिकल सुपरिटेंडेंट कलीग्स, डीडीए, माय वेरी डियर नर्सिंग कलीग्स विद इन द डिपार्टमेंट एंड द एंटायर पिक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट वी नो एज एम्स, स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ टुडे, स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ द पास्ट, एम्सोनियंस, मेंबर्स ऑफ एम्स स्टाफ in all departments in this great organization. Thank you very much. I'll first like to pay my tribute and homage to the members of the extended family of AIIMS who lost their lives in COVID fight. You set a great example in the service of the nation. We salute you. Thank you, Dr. Mehban Singh, Dr. Srivastav, Dr. I.C. Verma, Veena Ji, Dr. Bhutani, Dr. Vidyasagar, Doug. Thank you, colleagues. Thank you, Ashok. Thank you, friends, for all the good things that you said, all the nice things that you said, all the sentiments that you expressed, and of course, it has touched my heart. Thank you for organizing a get together in difficult times, but done so ingenuously, with ingenuity and with innovation, but deeply with love and affection and a great connect. I'm truly grateful. I'm grateful to a large fraternity of friends, teachers, colleagues, fellow pediatricians who are on the VC. Truly grateful for your time and your presence. Let me begin where the journey began. So I came here on when I became adult, actually by the date, because on my 18th birthday, the 1st of August 1972, I walked into this very preclinical block, the portals of the All India Institute of Medical Sciences, a temple of learning and temple of service. For the first teaching session in the demonstration room of the Department of Anatomy right here. And before that, a couple of things had already happened. Professor J.S. Guleria had done medical examination on us, the entire batch, about 4 days earlier, sir. I was assigned roll number 858, and I was assigned a room, hostel 4, room 4. But the day I joined the teaching program, as a student, the life changed. The All India Institute of Medical Sciences is my most precious blessing in life. Couldn't have asked for anything more. And I cannot thank Almighty for this blessing today and ever. Whatever I am is because of our beloved institute that gave me, you, a unique identity, and things change with that unique identity. And also, the institute opens opportunities, the gateway of opportunities that are not easy to come by in other situations. I want us to always remember that, and I always remember this. We are nothing. Here, those of us who are sitting, I'm nothing. I'm just 3%. 97% of what we are, what I am, is because of this great institution. The institution, sir, as you said, once you become part of the institution, it overwhelms you. It becomes your soul. And that is how it is for me, my life and blood. So it is a very small giving back if we give our sweat to this institution in the service of the nation. And I hope I try to do that. I salute my alma mater and I salute my karma bhumi. Salam Ames. Long live Ames. You know, having come here in the journey, you felt so secure. There was one Mr. Kaushal who was in charge of the hostel. What a lovely person he was. So he would allow you to stay in the hostel room even when you are supposed to be not in the hostel because you finished a particular term. He'll do it illegally because he thought it is the right thing to do to help a student. And we had Mr. Dhingra, you would know, who always will bend the rules for sincere people. When you are honest and you're telling, I have a difficulty in paying fees for another 2 weeks for some reason. You had persons like Mrs. Bhatia, I recall her, like a mother to us. I know you, some of us can connect. Mr. Bhatia always will take care. You felt so secure. You felt so at home, so much at home. We had Dean Dr. B.K. Anand, who loved us as children. And I'll come to Dr. Ramalingaswamy as my inspiration in a moment. So the institute has been a great place. It was different. You felt wanted. You felt safe. You felt secure. You felt like having a mission in your life. And in the path, we made friends. I was a batch of 50, a wonderful batch, 17th batch. Simple people, selfless people. I adore and admire their company. In this journey, sir, I met inspiring mentors and role models. Dr. Ramalingaswamy, our director, whose towering achievements, vision, and intellectual breadth from science to public health, from biology to clinical sciences, to cell, was an inspiration to us. Professor O.P. Ghai, my teacher and guide, was my role model. Professor Mehrban Singh, my teacher and my idol, held my hand and guided me. And of course, Dr. Raj Pan, my very dear friend, philosopher and mentor, whom we miss so dearly to state. My neonatology mentors, Dharmapuri Vidyasagar, whom you saw from University of Illinois, Dr. Vinod Bhutani from University of Pennsylvania, then my medical education mentors, Dr. Usha Nair and Dr. Kusum Verma, and my research, education and public health mentors, Dr. Lalit Nath and a very humble person, Dr. Suresh Kapoor, of all wonderful people who told us about equity, service for the poor, and the public health dimension that encompasses all our specialties. And that was a very important part of learning at the All India Institute of Medical Sciences because of people like Dr. Ramalingaswamy at that time. I joined a department led by pioneers and stalwarts in pediatrics. Apart from Dr. Ghai, Dr. Mehrban Singh, I had the privilege of working with Dr. Ishwar Verma, Dr. R. N. Srivastav, Dr. P. S. N. Menon, Dr. Arya, Dr. Veena Kalra, Madam Bimlesh Seth, wonderful people, senior to me, they taught me, I learned many, many things and try to follow their guidance because they were too Our department has been unique. It has strived to attain excellence, to evolve into super specialities and sub specialities and lead the country in this regard. But it also has the deep underpinnings of core values to which Dr. Kabra, you mentioned. Accountability. Accountability to the brand of the institute, the act of the institute, and the mission of the institute. Team spirit. Seamless functioning as teams across units, across specialties, across cadres. Participatory governance and very deep fraternal ethos. I'm so fortunate that this department became my department. So I thank you for this lovely day, emotional day for all of us. But I'm very proud of your dedication. I am very proud of your achievements. I am very proud the way you are taking forward this department under our bigger umbrella, our own great institution. And indeed, this is a dream team that we have, the best team in the world. Thank you, each one of you, residents, scientists, research teams, staff, my office team. You have strong leaders on this side, you can see, and you have emerging leaders, and you have a great leader here, my buddy, my comrade, my brother Ashok Devrari, who's an inspiration to all of us. We work together, we learn from each other. We fought about 3 to 4 times, entire 40 years. It's been wonderful, Ashok. You have been a blessing, one of the other blessings that I had, to have a comrade like you. Let me now go to students. Talk about student and teacher relationship. Teachers and taught have a special bond, a special collaboration. A prayer in the Upanishad sums up this adorably. And I quote, and it's a familiar one. Om sahana bhavatu, sahana bhunaktu, sahaviryam karivavahi. Unquote. It says, may he protect us both, the teacher and the student. May he nourish us both. And may we both serve together with great energy. The essence of this relationship is to be able to serve together, to evolve together, to learn together, to be more useful to the society. And that is the bond that connects the teacher and the taught. After you join here, you are a lifelong teacher. And I assure you, students, your lives are changing already, forever. The institute touch will not go away. And I must say that you are privileged to have earned the AIMS brand. AIMS brand and nothing less. And you have earned it because you, by the dint of your own hard work, you came here. By your own merit, you came here. And this institution has the responsibility, this faculty, teachers, colleagues have responsibility to nourish you, nurture you, to make you more able as professional and more endowed with values to serve the nation. And that is the Guru Dakshina we expect from you. As usual, I'll say 3 messages. Some of them are already common, but let me say what you've heard from me earlier. My first message to students and also young faculty here, young colleagues in other departments, sir, with your permission, I'm addressing them also. 3 things. First, whatever we do, let us do it with best of our zeal and ability. I'm glad some of you remember this theme of my interactions with you. Do not take shortcuts. Remember what Aristotle said, and I quote, we are what we do repeatedly. We are what we do repeatedly. Excellence is therefore not an act, बट अ हैबिट. एक्सेलेंस इज नॉट एन ओकेजनल एक्ट, इट इज वॉट यू डू ऑन अ डेली बेसिस, वॉट यू डू एज अ हैबिट. एंड देयर फॉर आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू एम्ब्रेस एक्सेलेंस बाई प्रैक्टिसिंग इट ऑन अ डेली बेसिस इन एवरी एक्शन दैट यू यूज, एवरी एक्शन दैट यू टेक. मेक एक्सेलेंस अ हैबिट, नॉट अ हॉबी और अ सीजनल रिचुअल और एन एनेक्डोटल एक्ट. If India has to outperform other countries, it is all about consistent quality of work, consistent quality of our products, whether they are vaccines or drugs or furniture or an AI algorithm, and creativity. And what we do with these ideas, products, on a daily basis is what matters. And you can see how in the COVID phase these things are emerging even more clearly. And therefore, I urge you to practice excellence on a daily basis. We have to out excel other nations. That is the destiny of this, our dear motherland. But second is a balancing act that we need to do with excellence, and that's about values. Temples of learning not only teach knowledge but also teach character. You hear that word in education. I would use the word values. In our profession, perhaps we should say values. Excellence and values must go hand in hand. Remember, professionalism is incomplete without humanism. Excellence without values, or vice versa, is not good enough. Not good enough for the society and the country. I am very good, but I have rotten values. No, that's not good for society. I am good, but I'm not useful to the society optimally. I am performing suboptimally. That's not good for the society either. Excellence and values together make a professional a doctor, a responsible citizen, and a responsible karma yogi. Our path to salvation most of the times is through karma. So you need, I believe, excellence coupled with deep values. And I know and I believe that our department believes in values, practices values. My third message is to remember, achievement is a product of opportunity and preparation. Achievement equals opportunity multiplied by preparation. Opportunity comes with luck. It's a random phenomenon, as Dr. Bhan would say. It'll happen. And it does happen. In everybody's life, opportunities will come, small or big. But it is the preparation which makes it happen, that you use that opportunity for contribution to the society, and you may say personal achievement or professional achievement as well. If you are not prepared, what will you do with the opportunity? The only thing you and I can do is to be prepared, because as I said, opportunity is random. Luck. Opportunities will happen. That also is for sure. They'll come knocking on your door. Sometimes we don't even hear them. So what we can do is only to be prepared to serve better and to latch on to the opportunities. I want you to remember that. And what is preparation? Preparation is hard work. Sincerity. And making excellence a habit. And to have the right value. That's preparation. And therefore, I urge you that be prepared to make the best use of the opportunities which surely will come your way with God's grace. So with your permission, I'd like to say a few words. I'm mindful of the time, about AIMS culture. And you know that we have had these conversations, and therefore perhaps it is timely. AIMS brand is about its extraordinary work culture. One thing people understand outside the institution, at the highest circles and the widest circle, is that we are different because we have a different work culture. We are different because we perform different, but we, on a daily basis, practice a different work culture. And these work cultures come to us as inheritance. We didn't invent them, by the way. We are now making a contribution one way or the other. But we inherited them. And we got them from our forefathers. We got them from our role models. We got them from our teachers like Dr. J.S. Guleria, from Dr. Ghai, from Dr. Mehrban Singh, from Sujoy Biroy in our lifetime. These people have shown us what a good work culture is. And we have to protect our image of this institution, making sure that we maintain that work culture, we advance that work culture, we don't forget that those are the benchmarks set by our founding fathers, and they are the expectations of the society of which we are a small part. Now, what is a good work culture of AIMS? It's about a professor and head of the department being available at 2:30 a.m. for the care of a patient, a poor patient, because that patient needs that level of consultation by the senior most, needs to be operated. And there is a complexity about that head injury where only Dr. P. N. Tandon can come and do the job. And he would be there. He would have been there. That's AIMS culture. It's about checking the status of the sick patients before you sleep and reminding the resident on call. This is a true story in a way. To call you when the next blood gas report is available. And if he does not do so, you wake up at 4 o'clock. The consultant, the professor would wake up at 4 o'clock and call. And when you discover that he's performing CPR on that very patient, you rush to the floor. You are by the side of the resident and you are by the side of the family. I'm trying to encapsulate several things that define a unique culture that AIMS has stood for and will always stand for. It's about making sure that you always see your patient whom you operated before you go home and you come back again if need be. It's about regular evening rounds. It's particularly about how you look after the patients at night. I want actually us to monitor in institutions how often the senior most people come at night to look at their patients. It's not about 9-to-5 job. AIMS is not about 9-to-5 job. It cannot be. Don't even ever think that this is a 9-to-5 nokri. It's about being accessible to students. It's about collegiality, a flat institution where everybody is equal and respects each other, minimal hierarchy, delegation of power, delegation of responsibility, shared credit, academic freedom. Nowhere else would you have freedom that you have here. And therefore, it is our business to make use of it and excel. That's why we are different. And so on. I want us to protect this culture, build on this culture, strengthen this culture, record this culture, and mainstream this into generations. And we have a challenge there. In the recent 10 years, 7, 8 years, there has been a huge expansion of our faculty ranks and scientists. It is so very important that the senior lot, people like you, sir, and here, make sure that we have a connect so strong that these values that we have inherited and the culture that we inherited is passed on seamlessly, not by way of a diktat, but by way of practice, by way of persuasion, by way of embracing rather than by way of pushing. I think that challenge, sir, is real. And we must make sure that because there is a rapid expansion, the very essence and the core of legacy of the institute is not diluted in any way. We also have a role outside the four walls of the institute, and I want to say two roles. One, it is our responsibility to build institutions beyond the institute. It is our job to help other departments who have DM programs and set up labs, train their faculty in research methods, train their faculty in pulmonology, in cancer care, in difficult surgeries. It's our job. It's our responsibility. Forget these trivial CMEs. Do this deep work where you build and help build institutions. And second, of course, as you have seen and exemplified by Professor Guleria himself, play a role in the larger sphere of public health of the nation. Rise to the occasion, but not just only when there are pandemics or obvious needs, but also consistently to promote best practices, to promote preventive health, to reach out to people for behaviors that save their lives and protect them from illnesses and chronic disease. Help the governments, state governments, help the district administration. But remember, when you do all these tasks, do it after you have done your own trinity of mission of quality clinical care, research, and teaching admirably well. You will not be preaching outside what you don't practice here fully. And commitment to the mission of the institute within the institute will always come first. But I assure you, there is always plenty of time, energy available to you to do these tasks for other people, not just for your own visibility, but also for a cause. I like to see more science at AIIMS. What distinguishes AIIMS, even as a teaching institution, is the deep presence of science. There has been some dilution from the good old times that I am familiar with, but that happened because we evolved in many other spheres, particularly in the clinical space. But it is the science that distinguishes us from other institutions. Think about science, think about laboratories, think about discourse that is centered around science, think about PhD programs. And I believe that in the space of research, that is a very, very important area of work that we must pursue. In the end, it's my time to say thanks, and a lot of thanks. So first and foremost, I want to thank nursing colleagues. Nursing colleagues have been very dear to me within the department, within the unit, and all across the institution. I respect their work. They are great teammates. We would like to see how nursing profession and nursing sciences improve further. And that is one of my personal endeavors that I like to now pursue more vigorously after I step down from, eventually, soon hopefully, from the Medical Council of India. So thank you, dear nursing colleagues, and thank you, your leadership, CNOs. You supported our department always. I like to thank all my directors, Sneh Bhargav, Dr. Dave, Dr. Kakkad, Dr. Venugopal, Dr. Deka, Dr. Mishra, and my very dear brother, Dr. Randeep Guleria. Sir, thank you so much for your love, for your affection, and your support. We are proud of your achievements. We are proud of your vision. I thank my deans. I thank my colleagues in the administration. All the DDS have been very kind to us. I also want to thank each one of the administrative departments. I want you to understand that AIIMS administration, notwithstanding some issues here and there, remember, you're still close to a system where you get support and help always. Finance, audit, estate, academic section. Great people. They helped the department in the role that we are seeing here, but they helped us as students. I named wonderful people who nurtured us. The research section. such a large research enterprise is handled by a section which gives you immunity against audits of the government. They tell you to do accounting in a way so that you are protected. Respect them. I admire them. I thank them. Library, estate, hospital, engineering, security, hostels, CMET, CRHSP, Ballabgarh. I thank dear colleagues for all that you have given to the institute and to me personally in my long journey and my association with you and many others whom I may not have mentioned. My special thanks go to our partner departments, starting with the obstetrics and gynecology. Each one of the faculty members of today and yesterday, you've been very benevolent. Pediatric surgery, our brother department. OBGY is a sister department, particularly for newborn. Pediatric surgery, you are very kind to us. You've given so much support to our department. Pediatric cardiology, I'd like to pay my humble tribute to Dr. Rajan Tandon, who taught us pediatric cardiology, and colleagues at pediatric cardiology division, RP center, microbiology, where we had an opportunity to do a lot of research work with Dr. Kapila and others. Nursing college. I also want to pay my special thanks to Manju and our office team, Premnidhi ji, Suraj, Umakant, all others. And before I close, I want to say big thanks to my brother once again, Dr. Ashok Tiwari. Sir, your love is infectious. And as I said, you are a blessing. We were destined to be working together for so long, and it has been such a splendid partnership. Thank you. And thank you to Savita as well, sir. I'd like to also pay my compliments to my family. I thank my parents. I thank Mrs. Paul, who compromised her career and ambitions to support my journey. I thank my brother, Gurmukh Bali, Virinder, Vijay, and their families. And once again, at this moment, as I move to next phase of life, I'm truly indebted to the love, affection, and support that you as department have given, this institution has given, my peers have given, AIMS family has given. It has been a blessed journey. Thank you so very much. Jai Hind. Thank you.